My name is Stefan Groschup. I'm the founder and product CEO of Datamir. So classical Silicon Valley-backed startup. We raised a little shy of $100 million in venture capital. Our headquarters actually in San Francisco, New York, designed in California, manufactured in Germany. Again, we see ourselves as a very global company. The top three business areas are clearly financial services, telco, and retail. I would say 50% of our revenue comes out of financial services. Basically, 80% of the world's money transactions are analyzed with our product. So the big idea of Datamir always was that time is the most valuable thing, and that we want to build a product that optimizes on time to insight. The notion here was always that there's a lot of pain around static schemas, a lot of pain to predefine your ETL, your analytics on top of that, and that there's a lot of interaction, graph and path data that is so incredibly hard to model and make use of in kind of traditional BI landscape. So traditionally we said make big data analytics simple for everyone. By 2019, the modern BI platform is end-to-end, is Hadoop or container-based to scale out, has search capabilities. But everything else that I just described, that Gartner's name is the future of the modern BI platform, you will find in Datamir. We are an end-to-end product. So you have one tool that allows you to load the data, that allows you to prep and wrangle the data, and analyze the data. We definitely the best product in the market around security governance, integration, monitoring, data lineage, and so on. Let me start on that 30,000 feet view, right? Number one, we want to answer new questions. We want to answer questions that historically been very difficult to answer with the traditional SQL-based systems. We want to, again, focus on that time to insight. From the moment you load data to the moment you have your visualization, we want to democratize the data access. That's why we're using very simple metaphors in the user interface. And we're really focusing on that IT-led BI or IT-supported BI. We have actually a super sophisticated integration around Spark and Hadoop. We can look at the execution graph and run parts of the execution graph in Spark because it's small data and it runs fast, or it's larger data and it needs to run as a test, what was traditionally MapReduce. So we actually completely abstract that and choose the fast execution engine that is possible. We support Netezza, Teradata, Greenplum, Vertica, Sybase, MySQL, Postgres, MS SQL. I'm sure I forgot a whole bunch. Vertica, we support them all. A lot of companies using us almost as a data hub where we pull data from two different SQL systems, create a new, for example, table, and then push it into an Oracle. So as a data hub. The cool thing about our connectors is that they are bidirectional. We can pull data and push data. And where we really shine is around those enterprise operationalization capabilities, because all that I just talked about overlays the security layer, overlays an operational monitoring layer. You can't do self-service without IT enablement and governance. Some vendors went too far into the self-service space, and now there's a 1,000 installation of a BI product on a desktop and the data is disconnected. It is a very high risk to run your organization on comma-separated value files that you send around with email and then put pretty charts on. I really think if you want to do self-service, you need to really, excuse my German, nail the governance part. We understand everything what we built here as a view. Nothing new, right? We had that in Oracle as well, the views. But for us, we really took it kind of to that next level in the meaning of we have as many schemas, if you will, as you want. And that turned out to be the killer feature for example, for banks. The beautiful thing here is if you decide you want to change how you clean your data, or if you want to change how you sessionize data, you can change basically this view and things recompute to this view. We're trying to be visual, really, from the moment you import data, we do single pass histograms and data profiling that we show you instantly. So we believe on this end-to-end, one product, iterative process, this dynamic schema I talked about, and then rapid integration. This is kind of the thing where we shine. Again, time series analytics, graph and path analytics, and then we're incredibly strong also around APIs. You basically can run Datamir completely headless. The way way, I think about data more and more is getting away from this notion of a data lake, where data is stored and then magic happens. I'm very bullish on making sure to use the right tool for the right use case.